Hello and welcome to Job Shop Code demonstration video. My name is Vikrant Athavale and I am author of this software. In this software, we are going to have as a look on different forms that have been populated using this Job Shop Code Mac and how the entries are to be done. As we all are aware, there are various numerous numbers of operations that are being involved, and each and every operation requires its specific inputs. So without having those specific inputs, it becomes really a problematic area to come to an estimate. We have already programmed it in such a way wherein the complete flow of the software works in such a way you only get the required text boxes wherein the input has been required. We'll just have a general overview on this. For example, I am selecting now is the turning setup. In turning setup, if you have a look, you only have access to operation that can be done using a turning machine, like drilling, face grooving, facing, grooving, hole burnishing, ID, internal turning, knurling, OD burnishing, OD threading, parting, profiling, and all these kind of things. So as you could see over here, only the operation that can be done on a turning machine are been populated over here. Similarly, let us select an milling setup, and in milling setup, as you could see, boring, drilling, end milling, face milling, profile milling, reaming. So you could only see those operations that can be performed on a milling machine. This eliminates a huge amount of error in calculating the final cost, especially the fixed and variable cost. And it is easily possible to combine all the operations related to one setup in one block itself. So this is how the software has been designed. Let us have a look at the further operations. I have selected the setup in which there is turning, and let us have a look at drilling. As you could see now over here on a lathe, I can do is only axial holes. So in this, I have its depth of drilling, which is just one, and nothing to further select. I have its peg depth, which if you use pecking operations, you could add in these two details. Otherwise, it has not been needed. But similarly, if I select is a milling setup, and if I go ahead with drilling, see, now I could see its number of holes and average distance between those holes. So the software is designed in such a fluidic way wherein you could add in the inputs in right appropriate manner. So we could come to an final costing which has a realistic timing as per your shop floor details. Similarly, if I change from drilling and if I enter into say an area of end milling, my whole requirement block completely changes. Let us come down to rectangular boss. See, the whole thing changes. Let us come down to one slot. My required text boxes changes. Whereas this remains constant, it is simply because these are the tooling details for milling, in which I need a surface speed, I need a speed per tooth, I need the depth of cut, I need what will be the diameter of the end mill or the cutter, I need the number of teeth on the tool, as well as I need what will be the step over dia. Let us have a look at turning again, and over here let us go to face grooving. As soon as this face grooving has been selected, you could see only those distance, those text boxes where the groove details are been required. Like in face grooving, we are mainly concerned with the width of the groove, because based on the width of the grooving tip, this will have a resemblance. Then depth of the groove, then groove PCD. Since we are doing this grooving operation on the facing surface, we require the PCD, that is pitch circle diameter, to find out the RPM. And if I go from face grooving, if I come down to normal grooving operation, that is on the diameter, my text boxes changes. It asks me for groove start dia, groove depth, and width of the groove. So that's how we are going to work with the complete layout and programming. So a huge amount of work has been done on the complete flow of this software so that the errors could be minimized, and the person who is working with the software understands the values which are been required to come to an cycle time of each and every individual operations. Thanks for watching this video. This was Vikrant Athavale. I would request you to have a look at each and every video, because there are a lot of features involved with this software, and you need to go through all the video to understand them and use the software to the optimum levels. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.